बट नाउ द सेकेंड मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट सेक्शन इन माइक्रोबायोलॉजी दैट इज वायरोलॉजी. सो द वर्ल्ड ऑफ बैक्टीरिया इज कॉन्स्टेंट एक्सेप्ट ड्रग रेजिस्टेंस. देर इज नो न्यूअर अपडेट्स इन बैक्टीरियोलॉजी. मोस्ट ऑफ द आई मीन इन लास्ट 10 और 15 ईयर्स देर इज नो न्यू बैक्टीरिया विच हैव बीन डिस्कवर्ड. नो pandemics or threat is going on because of bacteria. Whatever is happening in last few years, pandemics, epidemics, threat, all those are due to viruses. You talk about Ebola virus in 2014, you talk about Zika virus in 2016, or you talk about H1N1 in 2009 and 2015. So most of the viral most of the outbreaks, epidemics and pandemics in the recent years are due to viruses. So unlike before, now you have to give equally importance to virology like bacteriology. Okay, so with this let us now start the first chapter, that is introduction to virology. What is the difference between a bacteria and a virus? Bacteria and virus, the main difference is viruses are obligate intracellular. Viruses cannot grow on artificial medium. Bacteria, they have both DNA and RNA. Whereas viruses, they have either DNA or RNA, but never both. Viruses, they say that they divide by a complex way of cell division. Whereas bacteria, they divide by binary fission. Bacteria, they have ribosome. Viruses, even the ribosome will be absent. So they are the most primitive microorganism. They say that viruses are below the definition of prokaryotes. Viruses do not fit into even prokaryotes also. Okay. So coming to the classification, as I told you, viruses are classified into DNA and RNA viruses. DNA viruses, examples, 3P stands for pox, parvo and papova, 2H stands for herpes, and which hepatitis? B. And AB stands for adenovirus and bacteriophage. That's all. The spectrum of DNA viruses are limited. Very few DNA viruses are there. Most of the viruses are RNA viruses. If you the various families are there, like myxovirus, arboviruses, a myxovirus, it could be paramyxo or orthomyxo, arboviruses, other hepatitis viruses, picorna, which includes polio, rabies, retroviruses like HIV, reoviruses like rotavirus, okay, so on. Like that, there are many other miscellaneous viruses like Ebola virus, etc. Okay, so most of the viruses are RNA viruses. Which is the largest virus? The largest virus is a DNA virus, pox. The smallest virus is also a DNA virus. Most of the DNA virus, they have a double stranded DNA, except parvo, which possesses a single stranded DNA. Similarly, most of the RNA viruses are single stranded, except reovirus, they have double stranded RNA. Okay, what about HIV? HIV has single stranded or double stranded? They say that HIV has two copies of single stranded RNA. Two copies of single stranded RNA. Then there are some RNA viruses which have segmented RNA. Segmented RNA, example, they say that there is a code for this BRA. Stands for Bunia, influenza, rotavirus, reovirus, and arena virus. Okay, influenza virus has got 8 segments, rotavirus has got 11 segments. Fine. Coming to the morphology of virus, viral morphology is nothing but they have a capsid which is surrounded by nucleic acid. Capsid is composed of small protein units called as capsomere, and the relationship of capsid to nucleic acid determines the symmetry of the virus. Symmetry of the virus is the nucleic acid and the capsid, how they are arranged to each other. There are two important symmetry, icosahedron symmetry, where the capsid forms a hexagonal shaped structure surrounding the nucleic acid, whereas there is a helical symmetry where the capsid circles like a helix surrounding the nucleic acid, which is common. Icosahedron symmetry is the most common variety. Except there are certain RNA viruses which are we can remember as MRF BAT, stands for Mixo, okay, Rhabdo, Filovirus, and Bunia virus. These are the few exceptional viruses that have helical symmetry. They have helical symmetry, Mixo, Rhabdo, Filo, and Bunia virus. And of course, pox virus has a complex symmetry, whereas most of the other viruses, they have icosahedron symmetry. Okay. Certain viruses surrounding the capsid, another layer of structure will be there, which is called as envelope. Not all, but some viruses will have an outer structure called as envelope. So let us discuss what is envelope. Envelope is nothing but it is a lipoproteinous structure, lipoproteinous coat. Okay. They have a protein part, they have a lipid part. They have a protein part, they have a lipid part. The outer covering is the lipid part. And the embedded structures are the protein part. This is how the envelope is designed. The protein part is of course virus coded. Like any part of the other virus, even the protein part of the envelope is virus coded. But the peculiarity is the lipid part of the envelope is derived from host cell membrane. The lipid part of the envelope is derived from host cell membrane. Okay, it is derived from host cell membrane. So, which part of the virus is not virus coded? Answer is the lipid part of the envelope. Most of the viruses are enveloped, whereas few viruses which are non-enveloped. And please remember, non-enveloped viruses are more resistant टू डिसइन्फेक्शन एंड हीट, दे आर मोर रेजिस्टेंट टू डिसइन्फेक्शन एंड हीट. सो ओनली फ्यू वायरसेस आर नॉन एनवलप्ड. अमॉन्ग द डीएनए वायरस द नॉन एनवलप्ड वायरसेस आर पाप, स्टैंड्स फॉर पार्वो, एडेनो एंड पापोवा. अमॉन्ग द आरएनए वायरसेस इट इज पार्क, स्टैंड्स फॉर पोलियो, दैट इज पिकोर्ना, एस्ट्रो, रियो एंड कैल्सी, प्लस इवन हेपेटाइटिस ए एंड ई, दे आर ऑल्सो नॉन एनवलप्ड. हेपेटाइटिस ए एंड ई आर अगेन नॉन एनवलप्ड वायरसेस. Fine. So this is about viral morphology. Coming to viral replication, as I told you earlier, viruses, they replicate in a complex manner. Unlike bacteria which replicate by binary fission, viruses, they have a complex way of cell division which can be sequentially grouped into various steps. First step is attachment, then penetration, uncoating, then the replication stage or the biosynthesis step, then maturation and assembly, and finally you have a release. Okay, so these are the various steps. Among these, which step decides that which virus is going to happen, going to infect which cell? Which is the step that decides which virus going to infect which cell? It is the attachment step, which is the most specific because it involves the receptor interaction. Like example for HIV, the GP120 of HIV binds to CD4 molecule of host cell. So it involves the receptor interaction that decides which virus infects which cell, followed by penetration. So first step is attachment, where the specific receptors bind to each other, followed by the virus goes inside penetration. After that, there is an uncoating step where the capsid is lysed, destroyed, and the nucleic acid is released. So the capsid is destroyed and the nucleic acid is released. This nucleic acid then will be subjected to biosynthesis. It will replicate either in the cytoplasm or in the nucleus. Host cell will have nucleus also. So some viruses will replicate in cytoplasm, some viruses will replicate in nucleus. So in this context, I want to tell you into the detail. They say that most of the DNA virus, they replicate in the DNA will be replicated in nucleus, except that which is the largest DNA virus. Pox is the only exception because it is so large that it will replicate in cytoplasm itself. Hepatitis B is again one more exception, partly nucleus, partly cytoplasm. Otherwise, most of the DNA viruses, they replicate in nucleus. The DNA is replicated in nucleus. See, replication means what? In the replication step, the biosynthesis take place. Biosynthesis means all the viral structures will be produced. All the viral structure means it is the nucleic acid as well as the capsid proteins. Proteins are translated always in cytoplasm. Whereas for DNA viruses, the DNA alone is replicated in nucleus. If it is RNA virus, most of the RNA virus, the RNA is replicated in cytoplasm. Except, you know the answer, HIV. HIV goes and integrates with the host cell chromosome. So, HIV replicate in nucleus as well as influenza virus. This also replicate in nucleus. Whereas, the proteins of RNA viruses, they always replicate, I mean they, the biosynthesis occur in cytoplasm. In this context, I want to tell you one thing. The single stranded RNA viruses are classified as either positive strand RNA virus or negative strand RNA virus. This classification is mainly dependent on whether the RNA has a positive polarity or a negative polarity. They say that the positive sense, most of the RNA viruses are positive sense RNA virus, except MR. MR stands for myxoviruses and rabies. They are example of negative sense RNA virus. What is the main difference between a positive sense and a negative sense is, see, they say that the positive sense RNA virus, the RNA itself act as mRNA. The RNA itself act as mRNA and it directly undergo translation to produce proteins. And of course, the positive sense RNA virus will also replicate to produce millions of positive sense RNA virus. Then the assembly will take place to produce the daughter viruses. This is about positive sense RNA virus. In contrast, the negative sense RNA virus, the RNA has a negative polarity. It cannot directly translate. First, it has to be converted to a positive sense mRNA first. Then the positive sense mRNA will undergo translation to produce the protein structures. Similarly, the negative sense RNA virus can replicate to produce millions of negative sense RNA virus. Then finally, the assembly takes place to produce the daughter viruses. Okay, so this particular step is extra. This is the step which is extra in negative sense RNA virus. They directly do not translate, they have to convert to a positive sense RNA virus, then only they will translate. Fine. So, this is all about viral replication. Then the last two steps are assembly and then release. Release, mostly they will release by budding or lysis, a lysis of the host cell. Either they will bud out or they will destroy the host cell and they come out. Fine. So, this is all about viral replication. Now, we will discuss about viral cultivation. Viruses can be cultured in artificial medium or not? There is no artificial medium. Viruses can grow either in animal or egg inoculation or tissue culture. Animal mice inoculation. They say that mice inoculation, which is important for arboviruses and Coxsackie virus. Coxsackie virus can be differentiated into Coxsackie A and Coxsackie B based on intracerebral inoculation into suckling mice. How to remember is Coxsackie A, you have to remember alphabetically, first F, then S. When you inoculate the virus into the suckling mice intracerebrally, कॉक्सकी ए प्रोड्यूसेस फ्लैसिड पैरालिसिस वेयर एज बी प्रोड्यूसेस पास्टिक पैरालिसिस इन सकलिंग माइस. नेक्स्ट इज एग इनोकुलेशन. एग इनोकुलेशन से दैट एम्ब्रियोनेटेड एग हैज टू बी यूज and the embryonated egg has got an embryo inside which is surrounded by a amniotic sac and a yolk sac. Upper sac is called as amniotic sac and below it is surrounded by a yellow structure which is the yolk sac, and this further surrounded by a bigger cavity called as allantoic sac. And allantoic sac is lined by a membrane called as CAM or chorioallantoic membrane. Chorioallantoic membrane. Now the question is which part of the virus which part of the egg which virus will grow. This is easy to remember. They say that amniotic sac is used for the growth of influenza virus, whereas allantoic sac is a bigger, you can have a look which is the bigger cavity, allantoic sac or amniotic sac. Allantoic sac is the much bigger cavity. Hence, allantoic sac is the site for preparation of viral vaccine. And which vaccine we prepare in egg? Egg derived vaccines are influenza vaccine, yellow fever 17D vaccine, and flurry vaccine of rabies. These are the three vaccines which can be prepared in allantoic sac of embryonated egg. Yolk sac, as we have discussed, it is important for chlamydia, rickettsia. Among the viruses, arboviruses, and sometimes even Haemophilus ducreyi also grow in yolk sac of egg. Chorioallantoic membrane. Certain viruses they produce necrotic lesion on chorioallantoic membrane. These lesions are called as pox. Pox are the lesions produced by the growth of virus on chorioallantoic membrane, and these pox lesions are produced by pox viruses like variola and vaccinia. Apart from that, even herpes simplex virus also can produce pox lesions on chorioallantoic membrane. So this is how the various viruses can grow in various part of embryonated egg. Now tissue culture, it could be the whole organ culture. Example is the tracheal ring are used for coronavirus, or it could be explant culture, that is crust organ are used. Here example is adenoid explant used for the growth of adenovirus. Then cell line means the organ is completely digested by adding various digestive enzymes like trypsin, chymotrypsin, and various digestive enzymes you can add, and you can completely digest the organ and individual cells are separated which are then mixed with viral growth medium. And after they are mixed with viral growth medium, they can be dispensed in tissue culture flasks. Okay, there are specialized tissue culture flasks which can be used. Okay, so the fluid, the viral growth medium containing the individual cells, they can be packed in tissue culture flask. So this tissue culture flask containing the individual cells with the viral growth medium is used for cultivation of the virus. And these individual cells, after some time in the tissue culture flask, they will form a mono layer of cells. They will form a mono layer of cell on the base of the tissue culture flask. So when you inoculate the specimen containing the virus, the virus, they can infect the individual cells and they can produce certain morphological change which is described as cytopathic effect. So after some time the cells will die. You know that any cell line, the cells will die in some time. So when they will die, they will be replaced by fresh cells. The old cell will go off and which will be replaced by fresh cell. So after some time the cell line will be destroyed. They will not be able to revive. They will undergo natural death. So after how many number of cell divisions the cell line will undergo senescence, depending on that you can divide the cell line into primary cell line, secondary cell line and continuous cell line. Primary cell line they can divide for 5 to 10 number of cell divisions. After that they will die. Example is monkey kidney cell line MKC. Human amniotic cell line. And chick embryo fibroblast cell line. Okay. Secondary cell line, they will divide for 10 to 15 number of divisions. Examples. Human fibroblast cell line, and this human fibroblast cell line is used for the cultivation of cytomegalovirus. In contrast, the continuous cell line, they are derived from cancerous cells. So that is why they will have haploid karyosome. And because they are derived from cancerous cells, they are immortal. That is, they will have indefinite cell division. So it is very easy to maintain the continuous cell line. They will never die, they will have an indefinite cell division. Example. There are so many continuous cell line, HeLa cell line, HEP2 cell line, okay, Vero cell line, BHK cell line, McCoy cell line. HeLa cell line is derived from human CA cervix cell line. HEP2 is human epithelioma of larynx. Vero cell line is vervet monkey kidney cell line. BHK is baby hamster kidney cell line. McCoy cell line is derived from synovial cell carcinoma. So like that, these continuous cell lines are derived from various cancerous cells. And please remember, they will have a haploid karyosome and they have indefinite number of cell divisions. The question is how to detect viral growth in the cell line. Detection of virus in cell line. As I told you, virus when they infect, they will produce certain morphological change which are called as cytopathy effect. Morphological change in cell line produced by viruses. For example, enterovirus will produce crenation and degeneration of cell line. Herpes, you will have ballooning and diffuse vacuolation. Adenovirus, grape like cluster. Then measles, multinucleated giant cells, MNGs, multinucleated giant cell. This also is seen in RSV, respiratory syncytial virus, multinucleated giant cell. Okay, so these are the various cytopathic effect. As SB40 virus will produce cytoplasmic vacuolation. But my question is, do all virus produce cytopathic effect? No. Only few viruses what has been enlisted here, they only can produce cytopathic effect. Then how to know that other viruses are really there inside the cell line or not? There are some other method of detection of viral growth apart from cytopathic effect. That is, you can detect viral antigens in cell line by doing a direct immunofluorescent test. One of the antigen is heme agglutinating antigen. This can be, example, influenza will have heme agglutinin antigen. That can be detected by heme agglutination reaction. You can also detect the viral growth by the principle of interference. Interference means the presence of one virus prevent entry of other virus. Suppose, I mean, this property is like very peculiar. They say that viruses, they compete with each other. If one virus is present inside, that will not allow the entry of other virus. So this property can be exploited. Usually it is exploited to diagnose rubella virus. Rubella virus is a non-CPE virus. It does not produce any cytopathic effect. Suppose you want to know that inside the cell line, rubella virus is present or not. Okay, this is one cell where the rubella virus is present inside. This is one cell where there is no rubella virus. As there is no cytopathic effect, you cannot know the virus is there inside or not. So this cell line can be challenged by a known cytopathic virus, like, for example, echovirus. So whether rubella is there or not inside, you can know by challenging the cell line with a known cytopathic virus. Suppose if rubella is already there inside, it will not allow echovirus to go. That means after adding echovirus to the culture fluid, also the cytopathic effect will not be produced. But if rubella is not there inside, if you challenge the cell line with echovirus, echo will go inside and that lead to a production of certain cytopathic genes. So this is called as viral interference, which property can be exploited to know the presence of virus inside. Apart from that, the viral genes can be detected by doing a PCR. So all these are various method of detection of viral growth inside the cell line. Okay. So now we will discuss about viral vaccines. The viral vaccines, I will just outline the classification of the viral vaccine. The detail we will discuss under individual topic. The viral vaccines can be classified as inactivated vaccine, live attenuated vaccine, both inactivated and killed vaccine, both killed and live vaccine. Inactivated vaccine example is rabies. Rabies, both neural and non-neural, are example of inactivated vaccine. Even killed KFD vaccine, so also an example of inactivated vaccine. One variety of vaccine is called a subunit vaccine. This is one more variety. Subunit vaccine means it is not the whole virus, it is only a part of the virus, is one unit of the virus is used for vaccination. Example is hepatitis B vaccine. Here only HBs AG is used for vaccination. HPV vaccine. Here only the E6, E7 protein antigens are used for vaccination. So this is called a subunit vaccine. This kind of subunits are prepared by DNA recombination technology. Only the particular part of the virus is used and they are prepared by DNA recombination technology. Example of viruses where both killed and live vaccines are available: influenza. Influenza has both live and killed. Polio, OPB, IPB, which is live. OPB is live, IPB is killed. Japanese encephalitis. The 14-14-2 strain is live strain, whereas Nakayama vaccine and Beijing's vaccine, both these are killed vaccine. Okay. Then one more example of live and killed is hepatitis A vaccine. Both live and killed vaccines are available for hepatitis A. Yellow fever. Yellow fever, the 17D vaccine is live, whereas the outdated old darker vaccine is an example of killed vaccine. The outdated darker vaccine for yellow fever is an example of killed vaccine. Can you tell me the viruses where only live attenuated vaccines are available? If the example is MMR and two poxes, that is measles, mumps, rubella, two pox, smallpox, chicken pox. Can you tell me the vaccine strains for each? Measles, the vaccine strain used as Edmonstam, Zagreb strain. Mumps, Jerry Lyon strain. Rubella is RA27/3 strain is used. Smallpox is caused by, the agent of smallpox is variola, but the vaccine given is vaccinia. Chickenpox, the agent is varicella. And for vaccine, it is the OCA strain of varicella zoster virus that is given as vaccination. Okay, so these are the various classification of viral vaccine. Okay, inclusion bodies. are the morphological changes produced by the virus in vivo. That is, inside the cells. So the morphological changes produced inside the cell of human and animal body. These morphological changes could be either intracytoplasmic in location, or the inclusion bodies could be intranuclear in location, or could be both intracytoplasmic and intranuclear in location. Intracytoplasmic inclusion body, the most important example is rabies, where you will have Negri body. Other than that, variola virus, which produces Pasteur body, vaccinia virus, that produces Guarnier body, fowlpox produces Bollinger body, and molluscum contagiosum virus, where it produces molluscum body. Intranuclear inclusion body, Cowdrey has classified into Cowdrey A and Cowdrey B. Cowdrey A, herpes, which are described as lipsless body, and yellow fever, where it is called as torus body. And Cowdrey type B inclusion bodies are seen in adenovirus and polio. Similarly, the viruses which produce both intracytoplasmic and intranuclear inclusion bodies, they are measles and cytomegalovirus. Cytomegalovirus inclusions are described as owl's eye appearance inclusion body. Owl's eye appearance inclusion body. Okay. Then the shape of the virus, according to that, they say that most of the viruses are roughly spherical. Most of the viruses are roughly spherical, with the exception of certain viruses like pox virus, Brieg shaped, rabies, bullet shaped, Ebola, filamentous shape, and adenovirus, space vehicle shape. Okay. Other than that, most of the viruses are roughly spherical. Okay. So, herpes